Welcome back. I'm Miss Maggie, and I'm so glad you're joining us. Today, we are wrapping up our series called Game On. This week, we're going to continue learning about King Solomon. But before we do, let's offer our praise and worship to God by singing this song.
God makes us strong when we are weak. He calms the storm and he comforts me. We don't have to worry, we don't have to fear. God is always with us, God is always near. And we won't be afraid no matter what comes our way. If God is for us, what can stop us? So we will say, oh, I know he's always with us. Yeah, God is always with us. Oh, I know he's always with us. Yeah, God is always with us. God we serve, he is able to deliver us when things get rough. God makes us strong when we are weak. He calms the storm and he comforts me. We don't have to worry, we don't have to fear. God is always with us, God is always near. And we won't be afraid no matter what comes our way. If God is for us, what can stop us? So we will say, oh, I know he's always with us. Yeah, God is always with us. Whoa, I know he's always with us. Yeah, God is always with us.
I hope praising God prepared your hearts to hear more from the Bible. Remember, last week we learned that Solomon asked God for wisdom. Solomon's wisdom helped him become a king and a leader, but then he got distracted. Let's check it out.
Kids, so far we have learned to get our game on in life by spending time alone with God, praising God, and choosing wisdom. But we still have one more big idea to play for, so
game on.
Today's story is about
King Solomon.
Okay, we know that King Solomon was the son of King David.
We also know that he was the wisest man to ever live.
From his wisdom, King Solomon became very successful. He set up trade routes with the countries around him. He became extremely rich, wealthier than any other king of Israel.
He built cities, gardens, and even God's temple. He was so famous that even the Queen of Sheba came to visit him.
This guy had money, power, and honor. Everyone loved him. I mean, this guy had everything.
Well, almost everything.
Solomon wrote the Old Testament book, Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes.
Got it. In the book of Ecclesiastes, King Solomon said that all of the stuff like being rich and popular were meaningless. They amounted to a big, fat zero.
You see, King Solomon started out as a guy who wanted to love and please God. Then something happened. All of those nice things distracted Solomon from God.
He became more interested in stuff than God. Solomon put his wants and desires first and put God last. Big mistake. Listen to what King Solomon wrote. I gave myself everything my eyes wanted. There wasn't any pleasure that I refused to give myself. I saw what I had and I worked so hard to get, and nothing had any meaning. It was like chasing the wind. Nothing was gained on this earth.
Pause. Chasing after the wind? Can you actually chase and catch the wind? No. Well, that's why this popular, rich king was so sad. King Solomon realized that it didn't matter how rich, popular, smart, or successful he was, those things did not make him important. You see, fancy clothes, athletic ability, or having lots of friends doesn't make you important. Being the best singer or the class leader, or even being able to take a college course at the age of 5, does not make you important.
Say what?
Now don't get me wrong, you are important, very important. You are important because you're a child of God. Imagine how different the book of Ecclesiastes might sound if Solomon had always obeyed and respected God instead of letting stuff get in the way. Listen, it's good to enjoy the gifts that God has given us, but remember to respect and obey God. Unpause.
After King Solomon tried to find the meaning in life, in all those things, he realized he needed to respect and obey God because God was more important than everything else. Listen to what he says in chapter 12. And here is the final thing I want to say. Have respect for God and obey His commandments.
Today's big idea, respect and obey God.
Okay guys, now you should know our entire memory verse. Philippians 4:6-7. Don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray and give thanks to Him. Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds. He'll do this because you belong to Christ Jesus. God's peace can never be completely understood. Now let's see if you can say the memory verse before the words get eaten up. Better be fast. Philippians 4:6-7. Don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray and give thanks to Him. Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds. He'll do this because you belong to Christ Jesus. God's peace can never be completely understood. Super speed, go! Philippians 4:6-7. Don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray and give thanks to Him. Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds. He'll do this because you belong to Christ Jesus. God's peace can never be completely understood. Now how about some super turbo sonic speed? Philippians 4:6-7. Don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray and give thanks to Him. Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds. He'll do this because you belong to Christ Jesus. God's peace can never be completely understood.
It's time to get your game on. How are you going to respect and obey God? Well, you could give Him some of your time by reading your Bible every day, in the morning and at night. You can give some of your money back to God by putting it in the offering plate at church to help kids in other countries. You can even take some of your toys and give them to kids who don't have as much. And don't forget, talk to God. He wants to hear from you because He loves you very much.
Remember, in the game of life, to always
respect and obey God.
Solomon was very wise until he wasn't. Solomon allowed money, buildings, and people's approval to take over his mind. Solomon cared more about what other people thought about him than respecting and obeying God. Solomon realized he needed to put God first. He reminded us that respecting and obeying God were more important than anything else. Now, I'm going to leave you with some questions to talk about with your family. Press pause, read them together, and talk a little about it. I'm so glad you were here today. See you soon. Bye.